to any point in time, you should take advantage of the opportunity to explore as you wish. Is this Hesperornis out here all alone? Is there something wrong? I detect signs of a viral infection, but we'd need to do in-depth scanning to determine the source. Its wings are useless for flying, but it can use them to turn quickly and get a speed boost. Hesperornis have teeth and a beak they use to hold prey. The red eye is caused by a pigment in the retina that filters light. It allows for more accurate sight underwater. The lungs are flat, lie close to their back ribs, and include additional air sacs that extend into much of their body cavity. They can contract these to regulate their buoyancy. Fascinating. Similar to the Elasmosaurus, the Hesperornis has developed a tumor. It's located on the vocal cords. This is the likely cause of its isolation. Can we find out how they communicate when they come beak to beak? Try baiting some fish near the lone Hesperornis with a pheromone to attract the others. Excellent. Now to gather interaction data. It seems that they still reject him. The tumor is hampering his communication. The virus responsible is the same one afflicting the Elasmosaurus we investigated. I've modified your probes to allow you to take a sample for further research. Hesperornises are so similar to diving birds in our modern time. That these evolutionary traits developed so early is astounding.